Buongiorno ragazzi, nella video lezione di oggi iniziamo innanzitutto a correggere l'esercizio 4 di pagina 86 nel vostro libro che vi avevo lasciato da svolgere dopo la lezione su Google Meet. Allora, complete the text about Apple with the correct form of the nouns in exercise 3. When Steve Jobs and his friend Steve Wozniak started a company in Silicon Valley in 1976, they called it Apple. At first, they used the Jobs family's garage as their headquarters. Steve Wozniak was a fantastic engineer, and one of his inventions was the world's first computer with a color screen. The company needed money to produce this computer, but the banks didn't want to lend to the two founders because they were very young and wore dirty clothes. Luckily, they soon found a third partner for the business. His name was Mike Makula, and he put $250,000 into the company. This was enough money to make the new computer, the Apple II, and pay for some adverts to tell people about it. More than 5 million customers bought the computer, and Apple became a huge success. It never did much research to find out what people wanted. Steve Jobs said, "People don't know what they want until you show it to them." It seems that he was right. Successful products like the iPod, iPhone, and iPad have made Apple one of the most popular companies in the world. Ora andiamo a pagina 87 e svolgeremo alcuni esercizi di ascolto. Partiamo dall'esercizio numero 7 di pagina 87 che dice: Listen to the dialogue and compare your ideas in exercise 6. What advice does the girl's friend give her? Ok, nell'esercizio 6 c'erano due domande che non facciamo perché non possiamo fare speaking. Le due domande dicevano: What is the girl doing? And how does she feel? Why? And number two, do you ever miss your friends or family in what situations? Ok, a parte la domanda numero due, focalizzatevi sulla numero uno, quindi What is the girl doing? How does she feel? Why? E poi anche la risposta: What advice does the girl's friend give her? Ok, ora vi do un ascolto, voi se avete bisogno di farne due, ne farete due.
Track 2.09, Students' Book 7C.
Hi Jade, what's wrong? My brother James has just moved to Silicon Valley. He's got a job at a technology company there.
Cool.
Yeah, but I really miss him. I can't do my homework because I keep thinking about him. What do you think I should do?
You ought to talk to him online every night.
I can't. Because it's 2 o'clock in the morning here when he finishes work in California. I'm always asleep then.
Well, maybe it's a good idea to get up early and talk to him then.
That's not a bad idea. But it's not the same as seeing him every day at home.
If I were you, I'd go and visit him in the holidays.
That's really expensive. What's your advice for getting rich quickly?
I think you should start your own business.
That's a good idea. But what kind of business? Should I help people with their computer problems?
Yes, definitely. You're great with computers.
Track 2.
Ok, se avete bisogno di un altro ascolto, fate tornare indietro il video e concedetevi un altro ascolto. Ora vi do le soluzioni. Quindi, what is the girl doing? She is calling a friend. She should be doing homework, but she can't because she can't concentrate. How does she feel and why? She feels sad and lonely because she misses her brother who is working in Silicon Valley. And what advice does the girl's friend give her? Well, her friend suggests she should talk to her brother online at night. She might get up early to talk to him and she may even visit him maybe during the holidays. Ok, Now, I would like you to listen to the dialogue again and fill in the chart in exercise 8. L'esercizio 8 vi dice di riempire la tabella con le parole che avete sentito nel dialogo precedente. Quindi tornate indietro, riascoltate il dialogo e riempite la tabella. Quando siete pronti per correggere, fate ripartire questo video. Bene, correggiamo adesso la tabella. Vedete che è suddivisa in tre colonne: asking for advice, giving advice, responding to advice. Chiedere un consiglio, dare un consiglio e rispondere a un consiglio dato. Vi ricordo che advice è uncountable, non è numerabile, quindi non si può dire an advice, si può dire some advice, dei consigli, oppure a piece of advice, un consiglio, un pezzo di consiglio letteralmente. A piece of advice, two pieces of advice, three pieces of advice, oppure some advice, ok? Asking for advice. What do you think I should do? What's your advice? Should I? Ok, vedete che usa il modale should, dovrei. Cosa pensi che dovrei fare? Qual è il tuo consiglio? Should I? Dovrei? Ok. Come dare consigli? You ought to. Maybe it's a good idea to. If I were you, I would. Oppure, I think you should. Ok, you ought to, dovresti. Ought to è come should. Ha lo stesso significato di should, dovresti. La differenza è che ought è seguito da to e poi dalla forma base. Ought to call. Should è seguito direttamente dalla forma base, quindi should call. Oppure, it's a good idea to, if I were you, I would, usando un periodo ipotetico di tipo 2, se fossi in te io farei questa cosa. Come si può rispondere a un consiglio dato? I can't because, non posso perché. That's not a bad idea, non è una cattiva idea. That's a good idea. Ok, you can also say thank you, or you can say why not. I may think about it, I can think about it, and many, many more possibilities. Ok, ora svolgete l'esercizio 9 che dice put the dialogue in the correct order, then listen and check. Provate da soli a metterlo in ordine. Mettete in pausa il video, quando siete pronti per correggerlo ve lo faccio ascoltare così lo potete correggere. Ok. Bene, se siete pronti, faccio partire il video così lo potete correggere.
10. Students Book 7C.
Hi James, are you enjoying Silicon Valley?
Well, my job is great, but I sometimes feel a bit lonely. I haven't made many friends here yet.
If I were you, I'd join a local sports team. That's a great way to make new friends.
I don't know about that. I've never been very good at team sports. What else would you advise?
Are there any other sports that you like?
I love snowboarding.
You ought to go to the mountains near Lake Tahoe for that. But I don't think you should go at this time of year. The snow will be better in January. I know. Why don't you join a surfing club and spend some time at the beach?
That's a great idea. Thanks for the advice.
Ok.
Track 2.11. Students Book 7D.
Ok, spero che l'esercizio non sia stato troppo complesso. Ci soffermiamo solo su alcune cose. La battuta di Hugo, you ought to go. Vedete, you ought to go to the mountains, che è la stessa cosa di you should go to the mountains. Ok? Poi dice, I don't think you should. Okay, I don't think you should go at this time of year. Non credo che dovresti andare in questo periodo dell'anno. Se pensate che una persona farebbe meglio a non fare una cosa, meglio dire I don't think you should che non I think you shouldn't. I think you should study more. Okay? I don't think you should go to bed so late. Okay? I don't think you should. I think you should. Bene. Poi sempre la stessa battuta dice why don't you join? Per suggerire qualcosa potete dire anche why don't you, ok? Poi un'altra cosa che volevo farvi notare, la penultima frase, if I were you, I would join a local sports team, ok? If I were you, I would. Di nuovo siamo al periodo ipotetico di tipo 2, se fossi in te farei questa cosa. Ok, bene, questo è tutto per quanto riguarda la lezione di ascolto che avevo pianificato. Noi ci vediamo mercoledì prossimo con una lezione in presenza. Completeremo l'unità 7D, l'unità 7 facendo le pagine 88-89. Vi ricordo il vostro compito, che è quello di leggere il testo All You Need to Know About English alle pagine 88-89 e fare gli esercizi numero 1 e 3 di pagina 88. Vi ringrazio e ci vediamo settimana prossima.